Hello friends, myself Mahi Khemchandani, Assistant Professor from Information Technology Department. In this video lecture, we are going to see a concept of recursion. Recursion is what? It is the process of defining the items in a self-similar way. Here the recursion is what, in terms of programming language, what we can say that recursion is it is the function when it calls itself, either the directly or the indirectly. It means what? Suppose then my function name is ABC. Okay, so if this function calls itself, if it calls itself, it means what? This is called as my recursion. Okay, so the recursion is used to solve many mathematical problems, like it is used to find out the factorial of number. It is also used to find out the Fibonacci series. It is also used to find out the greatest common divisor. It means the recursion is the concept which has been used to solve the many mathematical problems. Okay, so first I'll start with the one example, that is the how the recursion is used to calculate the factorial of a given number. Okay, so suppose the name of my function is a fact, okay, and the argument which I'm passing to this fact is the n number, and it is going to return me the value. Okay, so before writing the code, okay, so how we are going to find out the factorial of number is what? It is the 5 factorial, 1 into 2 into 3 into 4 into 5. Okay, and it means what I can do here is that I can write this statement like in this form, that is 5 into 4 factorial. Again, my 4 factorial is what? It is the 4 into 3 factorial. Again, 3 factorial is what? 3 into 2 factorial. Like this we can write the statement. Okay, whenever we want to find out the factorial of n number, suppose my n factorial is the number and its factorial I want to find, so I can write here like this, n into fact of n minus 1. Okay, so this is the general form. Okay, so in programming what we will do, okay, in this function we have to check whether the one more thing, whenever we are designing a recursion function, at that time a programmer must has to take care about the exit criteria. Okay, so if we are not writing any exit condition from that recursion, for that recursion function, it will goes in an infinite loop. Okay, so here my exit condition is what? When my value of n is equals to the 1. So we know that 1 factorial is equals to what? It is 1. It means what? Here the function should not call to itself. Okay, it should return the value 1. So here I am writing, if the value of n is equals to 1, then I am writing return 1. Else what we have to do, it has to return which value? That is, this function is going to return the value, that is n, into, again it is calling itself, that is the fact of n minus 1. Okay, so this is the code for, this is the code for a recursive function which is going to calculate the factorial of given number. Okay, so how this main, how the this function is going to be called by a main function? Here what we will do here is that within a main function we are asking to a user to enter the number whose factorial they want to find out. Okay, so here I'm going to ask to the user to enter the number, then scanning that number, and we are going to call that function, that is the fact of n, by passing n as an argument we are calling this function fact. Okay, and suppose I'm going to save its factorial into the variable f. Okay, and finally we are going to print that the factorial of a number is % d f, the value of f we are going to print, get ch, end of our main. Okay, so how this function is going to execute, let's see. It means how the, suppose my n value is what? Suppose my n value is 6. Okay, so this 6 is entered by the user. So in main function we are calling this fact function by passing the value of n as an argument. Okay, so okay, so it is going to call, the fact function is going to call by passing the value 6 as an argument. Okay, so what what within this recursive function, again this the value of n is not reached to the 1, it means it is not reached to the exit criteria. So what we are going to do, this fact function will, the control will pass to this statement. So what this statement is, what it is, ds 6 into the fact of what, n minus 1, that is n value is 6, 6 minus 1, it means it is the 5. So it is going to call this fact function by passing the value 5 as an argument. Okay, so fact 5, okay, and again the control, while executing this fact, this current fact function, again the control is going to be a pass to this statement, that is the n into fact of n minus 1. So return n is what, the n value, current n value is what, it is the 5, fact of 5 minus 4, 5 minus 1, that is 4. Okay, it means what, again the same function is going to be a call by passing the value 4, okay, again the control will pass to the statement for this function call, that is fact of 4, again it is going to return fact of 4. Okay, so in this way it is going to call, it means what, your fact of 6 is going to call to fact of 5, it means this is what my execution, that is 6 into fact of 5, again fact of 5 is going to call fact of 4. Again fact of 4 is going to call fact of 3, again fact of 3 is going to call the fact of 2, and fact of 2 is going to call fact of 1. Okay, so when this is going to execute, at that time the value of n is 1, it is reached to 1. Now your function, recursive function, is not going to call itself again, it is going to return some constant value to a calling function, it means it is going to return a 1 value to a calling function. So 2 into 1, it means this value is going to be a return by the fact of 2. This is my fact of 2. Okay, so 2 into 1 is going to be a return by this. Okay, so it is again it is going to perform the computation, that is a multiplication. 3 into 2, again it is value is what, it is 6 into 4. Okay, so like this the factorial, again it is going to return to its function. Okay, so like this the recursive function is what, it is going to be executed. Okay, so whenever your recursion function is unfolding, at that time your computation is going to be calculated over here. So the fact of 6, whenever the 5 factorial is written by this function fact of 5, okay, so whatever the calculations are there, it is going to be written by this fact of 6 to a main function here, where we used, that is the fact of n, that is fact of 6. Now let's take another example, that by using a recursion function we have to define this function, that is y is equals to x raised to n. Y is equals to x raised to n. Okay, suppose my n value is what, it is the 3. Okay, suppose n value is my 3. So what we will do here, suppose x entered by the user is what, it is the what we can say, it is 2. Okay, and the value of n is equals to 3. So 2 raised to 3, whatever the value we are calculating, we have to give it to the variable y. So how we can write here, 2 raised to 3 is actually what, it is 2 into 2. Okay, so how, again I can rewrite this statement like a 2, that is the x into this 2 square. Okay, so in terms of x, what I'll write here is that x into x square. Okay, if I am going to calculate the x raised to 3 is equals to what, x into x square. Okay, and if I want to find out the x square, it means what, x into x, it means what, again what I can write here is that the x into x raised to 1. Okay, so to define a recursion function, so what we will do here is that y is equals to x raised to n, it means what? X into x raised to n minus 1. Okay, so we are giving name to this recursion function as a exponent, okay, expo function, and the argument which we are passing to this function is what? It is the value x and the power. Okay, so here I'll pass this value as a integer x comma integer n. Okay, so what should be my exit condition? It means what? To calculate this the value of this expression, so what we will do here is that we are calling this function exponent. Okay, initially what we will do, we will calculate the function by passing the argument, that is the x entered by the user, and the value of n, that is the power entered by the user. Okay, so this exponent function is going to call itself by passing which argument? That is, my base will remains the same, that is the x, and my power value is going to be reduced from n to n minus 1. So exponent x comma n minus 1. Okay, so I have to continue this. I'm getting the power value as a 1. Okay, so what I can conclude is that the 1 value is what? It is my exit condition for my recursion function. It means what? When my n value is what? It is the 1. So I am writing that I have to return only x, because x raised to 1 is what? It is x raised to 1 is what? It is the value x. Okay, so first I have to, whenever I am defining a recursion function, first I have to specify its base criteria, that is exit criteria, exit condition. Okay, so what I am checking my exit condition? My exit condition depends on a value n, that is, it depends on a power value. Okay, so if my power value, that is the value of n, if it is equals to 1, so what I have to return? X raised to 1. X raised to 1, it means what? I am going to return x comma, I am going to return x only. Okay, and if it is not 1, it means what? I have to again call this function exponent function. Okay, exponent function, by passing which argument? My base will remains the same, but now power, the power of that, it should be reduced by 1, that is n minus 1. So x comma n minus 1 is these are the argument provided to this exponent function. Okay, and this is the value written by my recursive function when it is not in a base criteria. Okay, and again, how the main function is going to do? It is going to use this recursive function again from a user. We have to ask the value, that is the base value and the power, n, scan into the variables x and n, and call this function exponent by passing the argument x comma n, and suppose I am going to save the value which is written by this exponent function into the variable y, and finally I am going to print like this expression y is equals to x raised to n. %d, and the value which we calculated from a this recursion function. Okay, so let's execute this code. If I'm passing x value as a 2 and n value as a 3. Okay, so whenever we are going to execute this recursive function by with the arguments 2 and 3. Okay, so your control will come to this line. Your control is going to execute this statement. So what is this statement? It is the exponent x, it means what? It is the base is what? It is 2. Now my power value is reduced from 3 to 2. Okay, so exponent 2 in comma 2, and one more thing is that we have to do here is that we have to calculate the value of x with the exponent of x comma n minus 1. It means what? If I am writing 2 raised to 3, here the expression will be what? It is 2 into 2 raised to 2. 2 raised to 2 is what? It is 2 into 2 raised to 1. Like this we have to do. Okay. So, the value written by this exponent x comma n minus 1, I have to multiply that value with the base value also. Okay. So, here 2 into exponent of 2 comma 2 is going to be executed. Okay. Again exponent of 2 comma 2. Here the base value will remain the same, that is the 2, and again I am calling the same function, okay, exponent by passing the argument, that is the my base value is 2 and now my exponent is reduced from 2 to 1, so 2 comma 1, exponent 2 comma 1. Now here in this function call, the statement which is going to be executed is what? It is the exit condition. If the value, that is the power value, that is n value, if it is equals to 1, then return the value of x. So here my value of n, that is the power value, it is what? It is the 1. So the value returned by this exponent function is what? It is the that is the base value, that is 2, return x. Okay, so this return x is going to be return to this calling function. So the computation done by this function is what? 2 into return value is what? It is 2. 2 into 2 is what? Again it is the 4. So the value returned by this function, okay, is 4. Okay, so 2 into 4, so the value returned by this function is what? It is the 8. So the 8 value is returned to this calling function, the main it is written to this expression, it is on this expression, and this value y is going to be printed over here. This is all about the recursion. We have seen the two problems, that how the recursion is used to solve the problems like a factorial of a number and calculating the power of a particular number with some value, with some exponent value. Thank you.